9th of July, top story today. The cost of dealing with coronavirus crisis now stands at nearly £190 billion after the Chancellor announced a raft of measures to help kickstart the economy.
Up to £30 billion will be used to help furloughed staff return to work, as well as a cut to VAT on tourism and hospitality. Let's get more from our political correspondent, Jonathan Blake, who's in Westminster. Jonathan, so many elements of the Chancellor's announcements. It's inevitable, isn't it, that there will be mixed reactions?
Definitely, and that's what we've seen to what the Chancellor announced in the House of Commons yesterday. As you say, an extra £30 billion worth of support, taking measures that he hopes will get the economy up and running again, or at the very least, ease the economic blow from the coronavirus crisis. But as the dust settles on those announcements, and among them to give employers a bonus to keep furloughed staff on until at least January, that VAT cut for the tourism and leisure sector, and also a Kickstarter scheme to try to create jobs for young people, the reaction will inevitably be mixed. And there are some pointing out that there's little help for the aviation industry or gyms and the healthcare industry, which has suffered so greatly as well, and the self-employed and freelancers who believe that they have been overlooked throughout this. But I thought what came through loud and clear from the Chancellor's interview on breakfast here in, this morning, was the warning that he gave time and time again, the same as the words he repeated in the House of Commons yesterday, that hardship lies ahead. And while he's clearly confident, or at the very least hopeful, that the measures he's put in place will have a significant impact and help the economy recover, he is not denying that there will be difficult times to come. And the Chancellor said this morning that although his message was that nobody should be left without hope, he certainly didn't deny that there would be many people struggling.
It is not possible to ensure that every single person is not impacted by what's happening. We've shut our country and our economy down for months on end. That is sadly going to have a significant impact. And I've consistently been honest with people that hardship lies ahead. And that's why we've tried to mitigate as much of that hardship as possible, much of the damage. Are we going to be able to mitigate all of it for every single person? Of course not. But when I look at the totality of what we've done, I do know that it stacks up as being one of the most comprehensive and generous set of interventions out of any country in the world. But we now need to look forward, and which is why yesterday we announced our plan for jobs.
The big fear, the big risk, of course, is mass unemployment, and that is where the Chancellor's plan for jobs comes in. And in taking those measures to try to encourage companies to keep staff on and do what the government can to create new jobs, he's clearly trying to stave off a big rise in unemployment. But it's uncertain at this point how much impact those measures will have and how far we will see unemployment rise. Labour say the government isn't going far enough and their response isn't yet meeting the scale of the economic challenge. And the Shadow Chancellor, Annalise Dodd, speaking on breakfast this morning, gave her reaction to one of the Chancellor's measures, that incentive for companies to keep members of staff on, getting a £1,000 bonus for every employee they keep on the books until at least January.
Well, we want to see a targeted approach. We want to see an approach that reflects that some sectors are far more heavily affected than others. To me, that bonus does not reflect a targeted approach. It seems to be quite a last-minute measure. You know, maybe government took this on board after the really worrying redundancy figures that we saw over the last week. Now, I'm not going to oppose it outright. It will help some employers, but I am concerned that government isn't taking the targeted response that's needed.
Labour then clearly calling for more specific support in certain areas, but up until now, that seems to be something that the Chancellor is reluctant to do.
Jonathan, thanks very much. Time now, 6 minutes past eight. Apologies there for the slight sound quality problems with the Annalise Dodds soundbite.
Other stories for you this morning. The cost of cremations has continued to rise despite restrictions on funerals.